Australia's Barton Lynch was the only surfer within catch-up distance on the ratings to American Tom Curran's lead for the World Championship. Lynch went down fighting in the first semi-final, defeated by the defending world champion, Tom Carroll. In the second semi-final, Sydney's Mark Ocalupo put in a powerful performance against Tom Curran. In a very close decision, Ocalupo was knocked out. I'm sure we'll be hearing more from Ocky in the future. Now with enough points in the world ratings to have tied up the 86 World Championship, California's Tom Curran looked relaxed going into the final. Carroll was hyped up, tense, itching to get out in the water. An 8,000 strong crowd lined the cliffs, and in the first wave of the final, up and riding, Tom Carroll making the most of it. Tom riding with his back to the bell's walls, a goofy foot with his... bit tense on this first wave, slips in the shore break. Next wave, Tom Curran takes off, but digs a rail, falls. Bad way to start the final for Tom Curran. Tom Carroll takes off again, drives to the bottom. He's only a little guy, but he generates a lot of power in his surfing. Very aggressive sort of style here from the two times world champion, Tom Carroll, from Newport Beach in Sydney. Down over the white water, makes it look easy, maintains control and looks to get back out on the green part of the wave where he can score some more points with some radical turns. Up and over the white water again, Carroll finishes another strong ride. He's looking good in this final. The young Californian, only 12 months younger than Tom Carroll, his competitor in this final, fights back on the next wave with some snappy manoeuvres. Curran has a classic Californian style, very smooth, but still able to pull some radically tight turns at the top and the bottom of waves. Milks every wave, all the way to the beach. Carroll takes off out the back, fades deep in under the white water, and leaves his turn to the very last second, driving back up off the top of the wave. Another strong bottom turn and cutback combination. Tom Carroll looking very sure-footed in this final against Tom Curran. Judges award more points when surfers ride in the most critical part of the wave, the breaking part of the wave. The surfers have to turn their boards constantly to stay in that fastest part of the wave. Tom Curran takes off out the back on another good-looking wave. Back and then drives back down to the bottom of the wave, very low at the bottom of the wave, getting a lot of speed out of his board, staying with it until there's nothing left to score on. Out the back, Tom Carroll takes a big wave right down in the bottom, up off the top, drives back into the pit. Precise timing is essential here. One slip and Carroll could fall. Inches of the white water and still has time to check his watch. Curran under pressure now, risks. Oh, a bad move. All five judges award a unanimous decision to Tom Carroll, taking out the Bell's title. For Tom, it's been a tough year. He's lost the world championship, but some prestige retained here in winning the Bell's silver anniversary. The boys celebrate in fine style. Wide World of Sports congratulates America's Tom Curran, and we look forward to the Australians coming back in the next year's circuit. Sandy, what a